the third difference. So first I have explained in the third difference what is the significance of acknowledgement packet. Whatever I have said is actually given here. So in addition to RTS CTS control packet used in Mecha, MechaW uses a new control packet known as ACK. After every successful reception of data packet, receiver node transmits ACK packet for acknowledgement or confirmation to the receiver or sender. If sender does not receive ACK, received by the sent by the sender node. So what is the case? That is, data has been sent, data is received by the receiver, receiver has sent acknowledgement signal, but somehow this acknowledgement signal is lost in the process of data transmission. Then what happens? So when the acknowledgement signal is lost in the transmission, so this transmitter actually waits for a long after sending data, waits long to receive the acknowledgement, but acknowledgement is not received. So what the sender understands it, whatever data it had sent, it has not received the, it has not been received by the receiver. Okay, so because had the receiver received the data, it would have sent a acknowledgement, but acknowledgement is not received, means the transmitter would understand that the data has not been received by the receiver. What the transmitter N1 would do, it would send the same data packet. So RTS, CTS, DS, data, all this thing will happen. Same data packet would be transmitted in case of the sender. Okay, but here one very important thing occurs in case of MechaW. So what is the scenario? RTS, CTS, data, DS data is transmitted, but ACK is not received by the transmitter. So what the transmitter would do, it would again try to send the same data packet. So for that, the transmitter would send the RTS signal. Now the data is received. Okay, so what receiver would do is, instead of sending CTS, now again it would send directly the acknowledgement signal for the data it has already received. So for the same data, if sender N1 is sending N1 is sending RTS now, upon receiving that RTS from the data which it has received, the receiver would not send CTS, the receiver would send directly acknowledgement. So this is a very sweet kind of change, which is a very smart kind of change, which is done in case of MechaW. So very important improvement, just check this process. Receiver received data, send acknowledgement, but somehow the acknowledgement packet got lost. Sender did not receive the acknowledgement. Now when the RTS is sent again by the sender to the receiver for transmitting the same data packet, receiver, instead of sending CTS, sends acknowledgement again for the same data packet it has already received. So actually this saves a lot of communication time, this saves a lot of bandwidth. So it's a very smart thing which is done in case of MechaW. So this kind of thing you have to write clearly in exam. If it is asked what is the acknowledgement packet and how smart is the acknowledgement packet in case of MechaW. So there is a third difference. Fourth difference is very evident. That is, Mecha is RTS, CTS data. It's a three packet structure, packet transmission. MechaW is a five packet transmission. So what is that? RTS, CTS, that is common with Mecha. Then there comes DS. So DS is a very important smart thing. DS is carrying two things. First one is the address of the receiver. Second one is duration of transmission. Okay. Then comes data. Okay. And finally, there comes acknowledgement. So RTS is from N1 to R1, transmitter to receiver. CTS is from receiver to transmitter. DS is again from transmitter to receiver. After some time of DS, transmitter sends data to the receiver. Upon receiving the data, receiver sends back acknowledgement to the transmitter. So these are five stage process in case of MechaW. You are knowing the OSI layers. So from OSI layer point of view also, there is difference between Mecha and MechaW. So there is something called as recovering from transmission error. Okay, so that recovering from transmission error, it takes at least 0.5 seconds time in case of Mecha. So if there is some data transmission, that means data is lost or ACK is not received by the receiver or by the transmitter. In all those cases, transport layer is responsible to retrieve the error or recover from that error thing. So in case of Mecha, transport layer is the error correction layer, and minimum correction time is 0.5 seconds. Whereas in case of MechaW, it is not transport layer, but it is the data link layer, which is responsible for the error correction. And this error correction interval, which was 0.5 seconds for MECA, it can be 0.1 second, 0.2 second, 0.25 seconds, or it can be variable in case of MECA W. So for MECA, it was transport layer and minimum delay was 0.5 second. In case of MECA W, it is data link layer, or it can be lot less than 0.5 seconds. That means what we are finding is MECA W is a more smarter way of error recovery, and the error recovery time is also very less in case of MECA W. That's a very important thing. There's a fifth difference. So you can write the differences in form of table if it is asked for 5 marks. But if it is asked for more than that, 10 marks or 8 marks, it has to be written in this paragraph form with all the diagrams. Now, two things are there. How the exposed node problem is solved in MECA. Okay. So hidden node problem, we have seen how to solve. So hidden node problem is mainly solved by the CTS signal and ACK signal. So CTS signal, when it goes from R1 to N2, the N2, that is the hidden node, it comes to know that R1 N1 link up is happening. Okay. And whenever the receiver sends a ACK signal to the N1, R1 sends a ACK signal to the N1, that ACK signal actually goes to hidden node N2 also. So N2 comes to know that R1 N1 communication is over. Now N2 can contend for R1. So this is how the hidden terminal problem was solved. How the exposed terminal problem is solved. Now check the diagram. How the problem is, what is the problem of MECA exposed terminal? That I will explain first. And then in the next slide, what is the solution? That will be explained. Okay. And actually that solution comes from the packet structure of MECA W. So exactly draw this diagram. So what is said is this N1, R1. So N1 is the main sender, R1 is the main receiver. First N1 sends RTS, then R1 sends back CTS, then error transmission. So N1, R1 link up is there. So N1, R1 communication is going on. That means N1 is sending data continuously to R1. And whatever N1 data is there for R1, that data is containing the R1 address. That is very important. And this data from N1 is not going only in one direction, because this antenna is not unidirectional. Antenna is omnidirectional. So whatever data is there from N1 to R1, that data would be coming to N3 also. What is N3 now? N3 is a exposed sender, which is in the communication range of N1. And N1 initially won the contention for R1. So N1, R1 communication going on. But N3 is in communication range of N1. And N3 wants to send data to R2. So if N3 wants to send data to R2, first N3 has to send RTS to R2. Then RTS would send back CTS to N3. Now check that. There are two packets, two different packets from two different nodes at N3. So first N1, R1 communication was going on. N1 is sending data. In that data, the receiver address R1 is mentioned. But that data is not only in one direction. That data from N1 would go in every direction. So that N1 data would come to N3 also. So this is one set of data from N1 which is coming to N3. Now N3 wants to transmit data to R2. So N3, R2, one communication pair would be informing. So first N3 sends RTS. R2 sends back CTS. So CTS is coming back to N3. So now the CTS from R2 and data from N1 both will come at N3, and those data collision would happen and both things will be lost. So if data N1 is lost at N3, does not matter. But if CTS from R2 is not received by N3, then N3 R2 pair cannot be formed. Very important thing I would explain again, that is data from N1 is coming at N3, CTS from R2 is coming at N3, because N3 is trying to form a couple with R2 for data transmission. And before data transmission, as per MECA and MECA W, it has to exchange RTS, CTS and all those things. Okay, so this data from N1 is coming to N3 because N1 and N3, N3 is in communication range of N1, and this CTS data from R2, this also comes to N3, and they too collide. When they are colliding, the CTS from R2, this thing is getting lost, because whenever data collision happens, then none of this data is received by N3. You cannot say data collision happens and N3 data is getting lost and CTS will be absorbed. No, whenever there is a data collision, N3 loses both data. So it is losing N1 data, does not matter, because data from N1 anyway is not for N3, data from N1 is for R1. But the CTS from R2 is lost at N3. Means what? This RTS CTS process is not completed. That means N3 is not able to form a couple with R2. That's what it is saying. N1 and N3 both contents for channel. N1 wins the channel and N1 forms a pair with R1. Now RTS was sent from N3 to R2. This is shown here. Now data being sent from N1 to R1 continuously. This data from N1, which is addressed to R1, and CTS from R2 collide at N3. As a result, back of counter entry keep on increasing unnecessarily, because N3 loses the contention of R2, but it doesn't know that it is happening because N1 data is coming and colliding with CTS of R2. So what happens? N3 thinks that R2 is busy. Though R2 sent a CTS, it is not received at N3, means N2, the BB counter will unnecessarily keep on increasing, and N3 would not contend for R2 again. So this is the problem of exposed terminal in MACA. So our CTS from R2 to N3, CTS from R2, that is the signal, to N3 like this is lost, and N3 R2 pair cannot be formed. So N3 R2 pair cannot be formed, and unnecessarily the BB counter in N3, it keeps on increasing. So N3 does not even contend for R2, and N1 R1 communication goes on smoothly. But N3 R2 communication could take place without disturbing N1 R1. But because of this collision problem, N3 back off BB counter will keep on increasing. N3 would not be able to catch hold of R2. So there is a problem in MACA. How can we solve it? Let's check that. Solution is because of DS. So first N1 is sending RTS. R1 is sending that CTS. Then very important thing, there is a signal of DS. This is a feature of MACA W. Whenever DS signal is going from N1 to R1 at the same time, N1 transmission being omnidirectional, this DS from N1 would come to N3 as well. So previously in case of MACA, it was not like that, because in case of MACA, there was no DS. Now in case of MACA W, there is a DS. So whenever there is DS, DS is carrying two things. One is address for R1, and second is duration of transmission that is going to happen between N1 and R1. So both this data comes to N3, and N3 comes to know that N1 and R1 is trying to form a contention. N1 and R1 trying to make a data couple. In that case, N3 would not send any kind of RTS to R2. Okay, so here there is no RTS from N3 to R2, as long as N1 R1 communication is going on, or for this amount of time which is mentioned in the DS. What next? Next, after DS, N1 would send data to R1, and R1 would send acknowledgement to N1. So this communication is over. After that, N3 would send a RTS signal to R2. R2 will send a CTS signal back to N3. Data exchange will is between N3 and R2, and R2 would send acknowledgement to N3. So this is the whole process. So how the MACA W solves the error of exposed terminal? Only answer is by DS packet. Okay, so it is written here, to solve this, that means to solve the exposed terminal problem, MACA W sends another small 30 byte control packet named data sending DS after the CTS received. Before sending data packet for R1 from N1, DS packet is sent from N1 to R1, and this DS packet received by the N3 as well. So DS contains two things: destination address of R1 and duration of packet transmission between N1 and R1. So N3 also receives DS. It is written here. It comes to know duration of N1 R1 transmission, so N3 holds or delays its own transmission for R2. So previous case, N3 was getting confused because the RTS packet from R2, sorry, CTS packet from R2 was lost. So in previous case, N3 was getting confused. Its BB counter was getting incremented unnecessarily because there was a packet clash at N3, which packets data from N1 and CTS from R2. those packet clash was there at N3. In this case, because of DS, N3 holds the transmission as long as N1 R1 is going on. So after the N1 R1 communication is over, then N3 and R2, they forms a pair through RTS CTS, then data exchange, then acknowledgement. So final thing is, there is no packet clash at N3. There is no increment of BEB counter at N3, and N3 R2 communication also takes place very smoothly after N1 R1 communication is over. So this is how the MECA W solves the MECA problem of exposed terminal. Very important question. Exactly this diagram drawing exam, and that would be very nice. Last point. There is a modification in MECA W, and there is something called as RRTS packet. So RTS is request to send, RRTS is request for request to send. This is given here. So what is RRTS? It's a very special feature of MECA W. I will explain that. So what is the necessity of RRTS? Before that, you have to see what is the problem that is there in MECA. That's why RRTS thing is required. So this slide actually explains what is the problem in MECA for a certain kind of N1 R1 configuration. So this configurations, you have to remember, just check previous case, R1 was there in one side, N1 was there in the middle, N3 was there in the middle, and R2. So it was receiver, sender, sender, and receiver. Next case is not going to be like this. Now here N1 or main sender is there in the extreme right side. Okay, so you have to prepare this well, and you have to prepare this from slide. Before going to the book, please go through the slide, understand all the things in slide, listen to the lecture, and after understanding, then you can read it from the book. So just check what's happening here. N3 is a exposed node. So N3 is not shown here. So first N1 R1 communication has taken place. N1 is the winner of the contention. So first it sends RTS, R1 sends CTS back, then data transmission takes place and other thing. Whatever CTS R1 is sending, same CTS is actually going to R2 as well. What is R2? So here N3 is another sender, and R2 is another receiver. So this diagram is exactly opposite to the previous diagram. In previous diagram, receivers were there outside and transmitters were there inside. Okay, and the problem was created. It was solved by MECA W. But in the other case, if receivers are there inside and transmitters are there in the outside, then also there occurs some kind of collision. What is that? So first, N1 R1 is trying to create a pair. At the same time, N3 R2 is trying to create a pair, and N1 has won the contention. Okay. So this CTS signal, whatever R1 sends from R1 to N1, this transmission is omnidirectional. Hence, this CTS signal from R1 will come to R2 as well. Okay, but at the same time, the N3 is trying to get the contention of R2. Hence, N3 sends a RTS signal to R2 as well. Okay, because N3 does not know that R1 N1 is going to have a contention, that R1 N1 is going to form a couple. So who is there at the problematic side? The problematic side is the exposed receiver node. So there's a new term. What is meant by exposed receiver? So R1 is the main receiver. Whichever receiver is in the communication range of R1, that is called as a exposed receiver. In the previous case, N1 and N3, N1 was the main sender, N3 was the exposed transmitter. What is meant by exposed terminal transmitter? Whichever is in the communication range of the main transmitter or main sender. What is main sender? Main sender is who has won the contention for transmitting. So N1 R1 pair was formed, N3 was in the communication range of N1. So whatever is the communication intended for R1, that is being received by N3 as well. Hence, N3 is called as the exposed sender. In this case, N1 is there in one corner, N3 is there in the other corner. Okay. So N1 R1 is trying to form a pair. For that, CTS signal is sent back from R1 to N1. Same CTS signal goes from R1 to R2 as well, because R2 is a exposed receiver node. What is exposed receiver? In the communication range of R1. So whatever RTS is sent by N3 for R2 and whatever CTS is sent by R1 for N1, both comes at the R2 receiver, and they collide, and the collision loses both the packets. So R2 is losing the CTS from R1, does not matter, but R2 is losing the RTS from N3. Means what? N3 and R2 contention or N3 and R2 link will not be formed because this RTS is getting lost because of CTS from R1. So these are very simple concepts, but proper drawing diagram and proper understanding is required. So as N3 is not able to transmit RTS to R2, it has transmitted but it is lost because of collision. Hence, R2 will not be able to send a CTS back to N3. Hence, data transmission will not take place between N3 and R2. What will happen is N3 will understand that R2 is busy somewhere, and hence N3 BEB counter will keep on increasing unnecessarily. Okay, so just check here. N3 is the exposed sender node. N3 is far from R1 and R2. N3 does not know that R2 is exposed to CTS signal from R1. So this is CTS signal from R1. N3 does not know that R2 falls in the communication range of R1. N3 does not know that R2 is exposed to CTS signal from R1. Okay, so RTS signal from N3. RTS signal from N3, that is this signal, and collides at R2 node with the CTS signal from R1. So this is shown here, this green line and this pink line, they are actually colliding. RTS from N2 is lost in collision. That is, RTS from N2 is lost in collision. So N3 cannot form a couple with R2. So N3 R2 packet couple is not formed. Hence N3 cannot send data to R2. That's why this data is crossed. It happens due to lack of synchronization at N3. Why lack of synchronization? Because in this case, the N3 does not know that the R1 and N1 is trying to form a couple. N3 does not know that R1 is sending a signal to N1, and that signal is coming and disturbing the R2 communication. N3 does not know that its RTS is lost because of collision with the CTS from R1. So it happens due to lack of synchronization at N3. How to solve this? Okay, so how to solve this? The answer is the RRTS packet. Okay. What is the RRTS packet that I will explain now? This is the last slide. Okay, so another 5 minutes. So modification in MACA. So previous whatever was there, this is a problem with MACA, because MACA is having only RTS, CTS and data packet. It's not having DS. Now check. R1 N1 communication was going on. Okay. And whenever N1 R1 communication is going on, during that time, after N1 communication gets over, or maybe N1 R1 has actually taken a pause, in this time, this R2 sends a RRTS packet. So this RRTS packet is actually a special feature for MACAW. What is RRTS? Full form, request for request to send. That means R2 is actually sending this RRTS packet, this saffron one line, to N3. That means R2 senses that R1 communication to N1 is over. Okay. Hence, R2 senses that there is no packet coming from R1 to R2. Hence, R2 senses that there is no, so carrier sensing. By carrier sensing, R2 understands that there is no other communication which is taking place. Okay, because R2 knows that N3 is in vicinity. N3 wants to transmit data to R2. But who is the motivator here? Here, R2 is the motivator. So R2 keep on sensing other channels. As soon as it finds that N1, R1 communication is over, R2 first sends a RRTS. R2 cannot send CTS without receiving RTS. So R2 can send a request for request to send to N3. So this RRTS is having address of N3 in it. The same RRTS signal is received at R1, and the address in that RRTS is for N3. So R1 understands that yes, R2 and N3 is thinking of forming a couple. Okay, so R2 is sending RRTS to N3. Address in the RRTS is for N3. Same signal is received at R1. So RRTS is received at R1, and R1 understands that yes, R2 and N3, they are going to form a packet or form a couple. So what does R1 do? R1 delays its transmission for next two slots, because R1 tells R2 that you take the next two slots and you complete your communication. So this RRTS is actually a receiver generated control signal which requests the sender to send the RTS. So this request for RTS So this is sent from the receiver, who senses no other communication is going on. Now N3 can request for contention of R2. So after receiving this RRTS, N3 now sends the RTS. After receiving this RTS, now CTS is sent back to N3 and N3 sends the data. So, and after that, acknowledgement also is there from R2 to N3. I have not shown the acknowledgement, but yes, when data is received at R2, as this is MECA-W protocol, R2 sends back an acknowledgement signal to N3. So this is how the exposed sender node can transmit data to the exposed receiver, provided exposed receiver has to take the charge and sense if there is any carrier. If there is no carrier, then this R2 informs N3 by RRTS signal. Upon receiving this RRTS, N3 sends a RTS, then R2 sends a CTS, then N3 sends a data, and this R2 sends the acknowledgement within two slots. And after these two slots, again the R1 N1 communication, main sender main receiver communication, take place. So what is said, that R1 N1 stop packet exchange after hearing from R2 that RRTS signal is being transmitted by R2 to N3. So last paragraph, it is saying that after N1 R1 transmission gets over, because as long as N1 R1 communication is going on, R2 cannot transmit anything, because in that case that would hamper the transmission by R1. So whatever acknowledgement is sent by R1 to N1, that will again affect the communication of R2. Okay, so as long as N1 R1 communication is going on, R2 checks for next contention period to start. So R1 N1 is over. Now R2 thinks that there is a time gap. Now I can transmit. Then R2 sends a request to send to N3. R1 also hears this RRTS request from R2. R1 delays its transmission because the address given in RRTS is not for R1 but for N3. So R1 delays its transmission for next two slots. This becomes a 6 packet transmission now, whatever is initiated by R2. So first packet is RRTS, then there is RTS, then there is CTS, then there is DS, then there is data, and then there is acknowledgement. So this becomes a 6 link transmission. So here I have not shown that DS. So after CTS, there is a DS signal from N3 to R2. And after that, data transmission from N3 to R2. And upon receiving the data, R2 sends a acknowledgement. Okay, so I could not show it because of space constraint, but whatever communication is shown between N3 and R2, it's a 6 packet communication. RRTS, RTS, CTS, DS, data, and acknowledgement between N3 and R2, it should be, okay, is done within this 2 time slots. Okay, so that's all. These are the 6 differences. So what all we have done today is we have explained what are the differences in, or what are the improvements rather, not differences, what are the improvements in MECA-W which is done over the MECA protocol. So first difference we found was the hidden terminal problem. In case of MECA, it was getting blocked because of BEB algorithm, which was having double backup time. In case of MECA-W, we have made it flexible, and it was not double, it can be 1.5 times. So every time there is a back off, R1 receiver is actually keeping track of the back off instances. Okay, in that case, whenever N1 R1 communication is over, so previously in case of MECA, N2 was getting rejected totally. So now in case of MECA-W, N2 is not blocked totally, but as long as N1 R1 is going on, nothing happens. As soon as N1 R1 is over, R1 kind of wakes up the N2. Okay, through the BEB counter value. So the BEB counter value keeps on decreasing by mild algorithm. So MECA-W using mild algorithm, because of that the BEB counter is reducing, and it's having a flexible kind of counter. So MECA is using double counter, MECA-W is using 1.5 times counter. So there's an improvement. Third thing is there's a packet exchange diagram. So in case of MECA, it was RTS, CTS, data. In case of MECA-W, it is DS and ACK, extra addition. DS is carrying 2 extra data. One is receiver address, one is duration of communication. And ACK is actually a confirmation of data received by it comes from the receiver to the sender. So sender comes to know that, yes, whatever data it had sent, that has perfectly reached the receiver. a very important improvement that if once the ACK signal was lost, then the transmitter again tries to send the data and it initiates the process by RTS. But now receiving the RTS, receiver understands that the transmitter is trying to send the same data packet. So upon receiving the request to send signal for the same data packet, which is already received by the receiver, receiver does not send a CTS signal. Receiver sends a ACK signal directly. So a lot of time is saved. So there's a very smart kind of thing which is happening in case of ACK packet in MechaW. Then modification in MechaW. Mecha is 3-packet transmission. MechaW is a 5-packet transmission. Mecha transport layer is recovering, is responsible for recovering data, and minimum time is 0.5 seconds. MechaW data link layer is the thing or layer which is there for error recovery, and the time can be less than 0.5 seconds. So in MechaW actually the error recovery happens very fast. Then what we had found was there is an exposed mode problem in Mecha. And how it is solved in MechaW? It is solved in MechaW only with the help of DS. Okay, so this DS signal is actually telling exposed node that yes, the communication between N1 R1 will go on for so much time. So in that duration, please don't transmit data or don't initiate the N3 R2 coupling process. Okay, so as long as N1 R1 is going on, N3 is not supposed to initiate the coupling process with R2. It is all happening because of DS packet in case of MechaW. And last thing, there is a special feature of RRTS. So to understand RRTS, this configuration is very important. Receivers are there at the middle, transmitters are there at two end. So the R2 receiver, which is an exposed receiver, it is getting blocked because of CTS from R1. Because of collision of RTS from N3 and CTS from R1, the R2 receiver is getting blocked. So how this problem is getting solved? In that case, the RTS that R2 is actually has to take care, because R2 is initiating the N3 R2 communication. So generally we know that the senders are initiating the process of coupling, but in this case in MechaW, because of RRTS packet, the receiver is actually initiating the coupling process. So as soon as the R2 exposed receiver finds that N1 R1 communication is not taking place, there is a gap because R2 senses the carrier. There is no carrier now from R1. As soon as R2 senses that, and R2 knows that N3 is trying to contend, N3 is trying to send data to R2. Okay, so this is a RRTS is a receiver initiated communication. In that case, first R2 sends a request for RTS signal to N3. And that signal comes to R1 as well. R1 comes to know that R2 and N3 is trying to form a couple. So R1, N1 communication is delayed for 2 slots. Within that, N3 upon receiving RRTS sends RTS packet, and the communication between N3 and R2 is formed. And after the 2 slots, again the R1, N1 communication can take place. So this is a very big improvement in exposed receiver problem for MechaW. So this is all from me at present. Thank you.